Our friends, yeah, they do go to school. Sometimes they'll be like, so how many hours of school do you do now? They'll be like two, and they're like, oh, we do six, that's so unfair.
For me, homeschool is just learning about the world and also learning to be yourself.
It's not a nebula, it's a galaxy, goddamn it.
As a person, I didn't enjoy school. I enjoyed it for a bit, but after a while it just felt repetitive and boring, and I don't like activities that are repetitive and boring, and also the toilets were horrible.
You've already done your mental math, so tick.
Home education is one of Australia's largest growing educational trends. It seems like more and more families are choosing to home educate rather than sending their children to school. In the past, home education families were associated with, you know, hippies who wanted to live off-grid, no electricity, that kind of stuff, or your fundamentalist Christian families. But increasingly, ordinary people are choosing to home educate.
Now, breakfast. Toast. Do you want some breakfast?
My name's Mervanwy Divan, and my partner in life is Daniel Jaffers, and together we home educate our children.
We're both casual teachers, and so we can accept work to facilitate home education.
Can you give us a yell if you need a hand?
Mainstream schooling has a limit on what it can teach and when it can teach it, whereas at home, everything is individualised and timely.
This one looks more decomposed than that one. Yep.
For many parents, they have this very strong belief about family, and they think that institutionalised models of education maybe get in the way of them and their relationships with their children, or maybe they don't agree with the way that curriculums are structured and they want to do something a little different.
We need to clean this bench up so you can have your ancient scroll out.
The education I'm having is a classical education. My mum is a very passionate teacher.
So this was when?
When Solomon dies and Israel is split up.
Oh yeah, that was a bit of a disaster.
I decided I wanted to do the NAPLAN because I feel a little bit competitive. I was in band 6, which is really high.
An interesting study that came out of the New South Wales Parliamentary Inquiry into Home Education in around 2014 showed that children who were home educated did significantly better in all NAPLAN areas and across all the year levels compared to mainstream school children.
But I've also been writing an article for Historical and it got published.
A child at home can whiz through a curriculum simply because it's one-on-one teaching.
Well, we don't need the big ones yet.
We always try and aim to finish any formal schooling before lunchtime so that she has as much time to do whatever she's interested in.
One time in the garden when I was digging, I found some bones, and that's why I really wanted to be an archaeologist.
Research coming out of a group in America that looks at home education outcomes suggests that Ivy League colleges over there prefer children who've been home educated because apparently they're really good at learning on their own, they're able to manage their own learning, they're able to manage a course of study, and they're apparently less likely to drop out of colleges.
The thing about space is it's so awesome, but it's so terrifying at the same time. It's infinitely big and it's so beautiful, but at the same time it's a dark void as well, and it would be very scary.
So Louis is on the autism spectrum. He's also a highly gifted child, so complex needs socially, emotionally and academically. I'm Carly and this is Matt, my husband, and we are a home educating family.
Another group is this unintentional home education group. Their child may be bullied, they may have special needs, they may be on the autistic spectrum and wind up home educating because the school just isn't able to meet the needs of that individual child.
So we'll do this, we'll have something to eat and then we'll go and jump online and do some of our maths, okay? So we started off using school. Some days he would go quite happily, and the other days we would experience a complete shutdown of personality. He'd hide away, couldn't talk to anybody, couldn't function.
He was exceeding his class in many areas of his studies, but was having great difficulties turning up.
After like 3 days, I was like, no, I can't do this. I need to skip for the day so I can calm down and then I can go back.
What do you feel like doing today? Do you want to start the questions?
Sure. Okay. The principal told us that Louis was not welcome to attend the school 2 days a week, which was the most at that stage we could get him to turn up. If he didn't go 5 days a week, he wasn't welcome to attend, was the effect of what she said. As far as I was concerned, that wasn't good enough and we needed a solution.
What we're making is a non-Newtonian fluid, which is when you hit it with enough force, it becomes solid temporarily.
Louis taught me about this. I'd never heard of it before.
Louis is an autodidact. We sometimes catch him surreptitiously learning in his room. There is no way that you can force a child like Louis down a particular path, because if he's not engaged, he will tell you no.
I could finally just get away from it. When you're homeschooled and you can go at your own pace, because there's no one that's completely the same. Every brain is different.
Yeah, we're just kind of free-spirited with our homeschooling. We'll go to the parks and Mum will ask us some questions every so often and we'll see if we can get anything right. But yeah, sometimes what we do, we just learn our carefree and just do it whenever.
An interesting group within home education families are a group we call unschoolers. Now, unschoolers believe in educating the child without a curriculum. They believe in following the child's interests and they trust their children that if they give them opportunities to do things that they're interested in and follow their dreams, that they will learn what they need to learn in order to succeed in life.
I'm Shay, me and my husband Luke and our three girls. We're eclectic, unschooly types.
Hi.
Acrobatics!
So our version of school probably looks like school holidays to some people. It's based on where they're meeting the child, where they're at and what they're interested in, with maybe a little bit of bookwork thrown in.
I'm just planning on drawing another person.
There are no age set benchmarks. So my eldest daughter learned to read at about 9. Willow was probably 8 and Harper would have been 7.
Who wants to do the flower?
Me, please. So 3 cups?
Yep, 3 cups.
You will learn from just your surroundings. When you're going to go cook, you'll learn how to do maths and measurements.
We've got 3 at the moment.
And how many are we going to put in each row?
3.
So how many is that altogether?
9.
That's it.
There were times I felt nervous about what my kids know compared to what kids are learning in school. But over years I've learned that actually they do know quite a lot. And when they're responsible for their own learning, what they do learn sticks. And they often go into subjects with great interest and depth.
When we were watching Horrible Histories, just the history kind of inspired us to make a timeline, because we like history and it's pretty rad.
I guess some people are like, really? Don't you want your kid to be smarter than you are? It's not a huge deal to me if they've got a massive career or if they're a stay-at-home mum. If that's what's gonna make them happy, then you know, I'm happy for them to do that.
My dream job would to be have an aquarium called On Point Aquarium, because my passion is to dance, but my favourite animal is sharks, and it would make a pretty weird combination.
I think one of the biggest misconceptions about home education is that your children will somehow be not socialised. We've found actually the opposite to be true. The kids have got a lot of time to spend with their friends.
I love seeing my friends. My friends are very close to me. I love seeing them a lot.
Children will join together in home education groups, so they'll have meetups with other like-minded families. They might do craft or horse riding. The only difference is that they can do it during school hours when other children are in school.
Taking on the education of your child is a big responsibility, but so is being a parent. And the nicest thing about home education is that she has not been required to conform or mould her personality to suit the school she's in.
Yeah, it feels like glue.
Oh, it does.
So yes, I have given up parts of my career. Yes, I could be doing a lot more. But having been unintentional home educators, I feel it's actually the best thing that could have happened for us.
Will you stop pouring it on my hand?